I'm Evo's Vox, back here with the Intel Streamers Bootcamp, and today we're going to talk about graphics settings and what steps you can take to optimize your live streams and capture gameplay for YouTube. Let's get started. Even for high-end computer hardware, live video encoding for streaming and recording can be very taxing on your PC. Even if your games are running well, you may find that your live stream is struggling to keep up or having some issues. In fact, this kind of situation is one of the most common questions or comments I get on my streaming tutorials. Optimizing your in-game graphics settings can improve your streaming experience and video capture to get things running much more smoothly. Streaming with unoptimized settings can result in a poor experience for the viewer and your chat staying empty, and such hiccups in a video can net you some less than friendly comments over on the YouTube as well. First, start with in-game settings, of course. Minigames like Rocket League and Overwatch Gear can give you plenty of options in the in-game settings menu just by going to Settings to mess with. Other games might launch a brief launcher to choose graphics settings before you get into the game, and sometimes you'll just want to tweak things through graphics control panels, usually accessed by right-clicking your desktop and choosing the control panel listing for your graphics card or third-party tuners, such as NVIDIA's GeForce Experience. These let you apply graphics profiles to your game to improve performance with a simple click. Lowering some of the settings presets off of, say, Ultra can do wonders to help your stream proceed smoothly. Funnily enough, I ran into this issue with Overwatch for almost a year. Both of my high-end PCs could run Overwatch at full 4K at like 90 frames per second, but my streaming program failed to keep up. I couldn't figure out why, but had not bothered to look at the game settings. It was running well, it shouldn't be a problem, but it was on Ultra Max settings. Lowering that to even just very high, a not noticeable difference for me, fixed the issue right up. Look for settings like post-processing effects, texture quality, ambient occlusion, and lower those first. Those are intense settings. Anti-aliasing, or AA, is a setting that requires a lot of processing power, but can also have a significant impact on your final video quality. AA aims to reduce the amount of pixelization and jagged edges you experience in-game. Generally, I'd recommend lowering your in-game resolution before turning off AA. You can lower AA, but before you turn it off, try lowering resolution, as you still want some kind of AA happening to reduce those jaggies. But if your game and stream is still running poorly after lowering resolution, then turning off AA entirely should see a big bump in performance. Resolution? That's the number of pixels that make up the image you see on your computer. Increasing your resolution can produce sharper images in-game, but can reduce performance significantly. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds is one game that I can run perfectly fine at 4K resolution, for example, but cannot stream it that way at all. Lowering the in-game resolution to 2560 by 1440 or 1440p allows me to stream and record it just fine. If you're digging around on your graphics card control panel, then you will also see your refresh rate. This is how often your computer monitor refreshes the on-screen image. Most monitors are 60 Hz, which means they refresh 60 times per second, though some higher-end monitors can reach far higher rates. If your mouse movement is feeling sluggish or much slower than usual, or your game locks to about 30 frames per second, confirm that this hasn't been set to something too low, like 30 Hz. It's also important to verify your graphics card service is enabled. Some graphics cards automatically install drivers to trigger your settings automatically when Windows starts. Some people don't know to check for this, which can mean that any changes you make to your graphics settings won't take effect. So make sure you confirm your graphics card services are running before starting your game after making those changes. Check your services by going to Start, Control Panel, Administrative Tools, Services, or Start, and then in the search box type in services.msc. Lastly, make sure you disable unrelated third-party overlays when you're streaming. NVIDIA Share, that overlay can cause performance problems with other streaming programs, the Windows 10 game bar that's enabled by default. Overlays like that, disable those and they can help your streaming performance quite a bit in some cases. Optimizing your graphics settings is a great way to start improving your gameplay and game capture experience, and the best way to increase your PC performance on the whole is to upgrade your hardware. I use a PC powered by an Intel Core i7 processor, which, in my opinion, is one of the best desktop options on the market. Well, basically the best for gaming. All Intel Core i7 processors feature hyper-threading, and that means you can do more work without compromising on performance. So, if you're like me and like to stream in HD, play 4K games, and even encode video all at the same time, this processor will take your PC performance to pro level. For more Intel Streamers Bootcamp videos, check out the links at the end of the video and in the description down below. I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and I will see you next time.